Hi boys and girls, I'm Morris. You're watching Morbott Gaming. And today we're playing a game called Vane. Complete disclosure, I am replaying this game. I played it and I recorded my first playthrough. And I gotta tell ya, on many occasions came very, very, very close to just rage quitting this game. I'll explain why. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous looking game. I'm not a big fan of the character design, I'll be straight up with you about that, but the world is amazing looking, and I really love the style of this game. But, oh, let me tell you, the camera and the controls of this game, they are something to hate. But, having played this game already once, I think I've got a handle on it. And, not to say that it won't be as jank as I can remember the first time around, but, I imagine I will at least know what I'm doing. Ooh! That wasn't very nice. That's pretty. Well, let's get going. Oh yeah. I won't rage too much about the controls in this game. Just be forewarned. And I'm going in completely the wrong direction because I want to do a little exploring if I can. I wonder if there are any invisible walls we have to contend with. Ah! I'll get back into the game. I just want to look around for a little bit. There's a little tree out there. Let's go check it out. fairly short game from what I recall. It's about 3 or 4 hours, depending on how much farting around you do. I might do a little... Well, okay, I guess I can't go there. Whoa, where'd this come from? Whoa. Nope. Denied. Well, that was kind of... All right, well, let's get on with it then. Oh yeah, that's... Ooh. I don't know what's going on there. Oh yeah, I am playing with mouse and keyboard. I do not recommend attempting to play this game with a controller. Not only I don't think it does it support like, you know, your typical sort of 360 controller or whatever, but I typically play with a Steam controller on my PC. And that thing is super customizable. Usually, I've never had a problem getting anything to work on that thing, and it's been whoa, what is that weird polygon? And it's been fantastic. But this game, this game broke the mold. It was just horrific. I could not get it to just feel good with the Steam controller. And from discussion comments I've seen on the Steam groups for this game, it seems like it's a problem a lot of people have. Like, people just can't use their controllers, or if they do, it's hot garbage. And anyway, land on the tree. Fuck's sake. Yes, this is turn around. So yes, mouse and keyboard. It's pretty much the way to go for this game. I don't know what it's like, 'cause this is on consoles as well, right? Because this was supposed to be a PlayStation exclusive game initially. Maybe when they play tested and realized how friggin' horrific it is to play, they let them go. I don't know. I want to go down there and see what that's all about. If it'll let me. Let's see. So yeah, I don't know what it must be like playing on consoles. If any of you guys have this game, and you've played it with the controller, maybe they got it worked out for the consoles. But holy crow, PC version not so much. I kind of like this exploring business. When I was playing this, I think I was struggling so much the first time around that all I was doing was fighting with the controls. Woo! Nope. So yeah, I wasn't doing a whole heck of a lot of exploring. See if I can land. Nope. Denied. Why am I playing this game again if it frustrated me so much? Well, I gotta say, in the end, once I mastered this ridiculous control system, it was... It was quite enjoyable. Like some of the visuals are... pretty wild. And I figure it's probably more to your benefit to, watch someone enjoy a game than it is to watch someone spit and swear and curse. So that's my kids say I swear too much when I do these things. See how low to the ground I can get. Make it like Star Wars. Oh yeah, nice. Come on, fly. Oh. I guess not. Get back to business. All that clicking you hear, hopefully you don't hear it. Be bashing away at my mouse to make him fly. Okay, I'm gonna thread the needle here. Here we go. Yeah! Alright. I think the game really wants me to land here. Meet my other crow brethren. Whoa, where'd you go? Nope. There we go. No, 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 no. Fuck. Sorry, what was that I was saying about not swearing? Oh my god. Land on the thing. There we go. Zoop. I wanna see if I can get my tips of my feathers. Oh, come on. Nope. Okay, so that's where I came from. See that flash? What was that all about? Was that a glitch? I don't want to jump levels. Oh, hello. Forget it. Ooh. I've never seen this. This is all new to me. What? Where am I? I love my little shadow down there. That's cool. Look in the wrong direction, Bert. Alright, well, before we... Oh, I see there is something blinking over there. I guess it's my crow vision. Don't they like shiny things? You know, a game, surprising how much fun a game could be, or enjoyable a game could be, when you don't have to fight with the controls every friggin' second of the game, which is what I felt the first time around playing this game. Ooh, you gotta smash! This is pretty. Very Blade Runner-y, eh? The music? Vangelis-like? Wow. I got nothing against that, but that's... Now... Looks like a fallen airplane or something. so you know that to make that thing break and have that ball fall, you have to find and you know, make those weather vanes all pop out the way they do and they catch the wind and all that. I didn't know that the first time I played, and I was just like flailing around for far too long trying to figure it out. And yeah, so just go around the landscape, find those things, make them catch the wind, and then come back and get on that thing, make all your buddies hang out as well, and the thing will fall and you can carry on with the game. I'm just going to take a quick look around before I do that. Just because I'm really in the mode of exploring. Like, what is that? That's... So yeah, before I must have gotten the prerequisite amount of wind socks or whatever these things are called, because yeah, these are the things I'm talking about. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I think I'm going to end this chapter right here. This will be, I think it's been recording for about an hour. It's about the first hour of the game. I think we've got a couple more to go. It's, like I said at the beginning, it's a fairly short game. But I really got to say, for this first hour, I'm enjoying it a lot. And I'll say a lot more than I was the first time around. Which we'll see how this goes. Because maybe if you do have this game and or you've tried this game and you've just quit in a rage, I don't blame you. There's a lot to be frustrated about the first time you're picking up this game, and maybe it is worth a second play, because I seem to be enjoying it a lot more. Less fighting with the controls, more just exploring and enjoying flying. Yeah, I'm gonna end it there. My channel is called Morbott Gaming. I'm Morris. I want to thank you for coming out and checking out my channel. Please hit that subscribe button, join the family here. And leave some comments, some thoughts, or anything you want to say. I'd be happy to hear from you. Until next time, I just want to say arrivederci.